party. It's the hotel lobby. It's the after party show. Can I get some cups, please? After the party, it's the hotel lobby.
It's probably worse.
Then what? Remix with the homie from the Midwest. Shabba.
Shabba.
It's a new two vibe. I suppose you knew some clubs. But don't approach this song. To chase you like Mo at Mimosa's. Catch us both coasters, racing twin poachers, boxers. To make you closer. Whoever come closest,
you've been warned.
But don't get the picture to the is drawn. Make your way backstage, baby girl is on. And we'll be drinking till 6 in the morning.
Yo, you are a snowman. It's your motherfucking guy.
Sure, guy.
DJ FNR, man. It's another Monday night. You fucking around the campfire. That's right. You know what I'm saying? It's the after party show flow. You already know. Usually, this is the part of the show where everybody takes a shot, but I need some cups. We ain't got no cups. We got some cups. Can we get some cups, please?
You already show so.
You know what I'm saying?
Carrot.
Lola in the building. Lola Bunny. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Carrot. Me and the Raw in the building. Covering his dick. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Special guest, DJ. DJ 7 in the motherfucking building.
You got DJ 7 in the motherfucking building.
We here, man. You know what I'm saying? It's the after party show. Like,
am I visible?
Ooh.
Oh.
Ooh.
Shots out.
Nina Raw in the building? That wasn't you? That ain't you? Nina Raw in the motherfucker?
Yeah, I didn't hear that though.
I said, coming to the Instagram. I switched it because Instagram and everything. Yeah, I said, Nina Raw in the motherfucker building. I said, coming to the
You know you talk fast as shit.
Want to get on the playback? On the playback? You ain't.
You know you talk fast as shit.
Yeah, you ain't. You got to tune in.
You must have heard his rants.
Maybe he's listening to it slow.
Where is
that? Maybe you got to tune in.
Because I was popping the shrimp.
Yeah. Yeah. Shout out to the shrimp chicken sponsor. You know what I'm saying? The shrimp and chicken sponsor, you know what I'm saying, for the night, you know what I'm saying?
I want to let y'all hear that.
Mm-hmm. Good.
We got a special guest in the building. What's your name is?
Shout out to
we got in the building.
Shout out to Blueberry. Shout out to Blueberry.
She is making it up.
No, it's jazz.
It is jazz. Okay, jazz. Yeah.
Your blue hair.
Oh, thank you.
Cute. Welcome.
We're gonna carry it though, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I'm saying. The after party show. Let's get the
shenanigans
right. You know what I'm saying? Get your
shit
right.
Shatian.
Huh? She don't get down with the brown.
She don't get down with the brown.
And I get down. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? The carrier.
Carrier.
NBM 101. Carry it the fuck away. You know what I'm saying? But we're going to hop right into it because we're going to talk about some shit. Shout out to my girl Ming. She had, she do sex demonstrations and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? So I was talking to her. She talked me into getting this item that she has. She sells a lot of items, like, you know what I'm saying? Whips, straps, chains, all kinds of 50 shades of. All kinds of crazy shit. So, like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so it was 80 wild.
Shades,
you know what I'm saying?
Of gray shit.
80 shades, you know what I'm saying? Many shades. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm in a joint, you know what I'm saying? So, I'm just like looking at, you know what I'm saying? What you gotta do, you know what I'm saying? You know, you wanna support your friend and shit. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm sitting there looking through the catalog. I'm like, what you got? This and that. Like, what's this? What's that? All right, bam. Okay, this and that. And, I'm saying, I got some condoms and shit. Shout out to condoms, man. If you wear condoms, I'm saying, you're real cool, you know what I'm saying? Man,
shout out to Rules.
Yeah, you cool for wearing condoms, man. Cause,
I'm a cool ass guy.
Listen, because I'm a cool ass guy. Save you from shit, because like you know what I'm saying, like because you can catch shit if you
real right.
You can catch shit. You know
like kids.
Like kids. you can catch. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like
we had
you
a
think,
conversation.
You think that's what I'm saying?
Three weeks ago.
Whole lot of. You know what I'm saying? So like you know what I'm saying. Shout out to the condom sponsors. You know what I'm saying and all that. But what I had bought this, like, it's like, it go on the back of your door. It's like a swing. It's
a sex
like,
swing, bro.
It's like, yeah. So, like, I'm like, all right, well, how, I'm looking at.
It's crazy because I was just talking about that, John.
So, I'm like, all right. So, I'm like, so how does. I'm like, so how this going to work? I'm like, all right, bet. So, you know what I'm saying? Boom, I'm going to hook that joint up. I'm going to put that shit together. I'm going to let y'all know how it work out. You know what I'm saying? That's how I work it out. But
Jordan, I got a pillow that's on in the diamond shape, and it keep her arch perfect.
I know what pillow
you're
talking about.
Wait.
How do you know what pillow I'm talking about?
Don't worry about that. I just know what you're talking about.
Okay.
Ooh.
Oh, okay.
That part.
Say
that.
Say that.
Well,
say that then.
We definitely in the motherfucking building, man. This is the after party show, and it's the part where everybody gotta take a shot. Come on.
What's going on, girl?
Pour it up.
I'm about to say, look, she over there.
Shots up. No, she good. She good. All right. Shots, it's the after party show. Yeah.
For the first time, and I ain't complaining about my shot being too big, y'all.
That part. But I'm going to hop right into it. Like, the question is, the first question of the day is.
Yo, don't start with me, okay? This is your first
sidebar.
Time being nice.
I'm just going to eat the taffy.
Pause.
It's the after party show. It's the wrong place for that shit.
Super pause.
Technically, you know what I'm saying? You're in a foul because you're not even supposed to have one of them.
Yeah, like.
I mean, yeah, of course.
I mean, you supposed to.
Okay. I mean. It's not okay. My Instagram said you started a live.
I started a live. Brand new on there. I got Miss Sherry from St. Louis on there. What up, Miss Sherry from St. Louis?
Fucking that taffy up right now.
Can you give me that real one?
Right. So, you know what I'm saying? We're going to hop right into the first question. It says, if you're in a relationship, do your hoes know your partner? And, like, do you put your hoes in place? Like.
Wait. Huh?
Are we asking that around the room?
It's gonna go around the room. It's gonna start from the right side. If you're in a relationship, do your hoes know your partner? Like, do you tell them, like, oh, yo, this and that? You sit them down. Like, do you all bring them to this table and sit them all down? Like, listen.
You the hoes.
I know you guys are wondering why we're all here.
But,
I jumped into something. So shit gonna go a little different.
When I see you on the streets, just
don't see me.
No, you can give me a head nod. Don't run out like say. Be like, yo. You gotta talk to me like you a dude. Like, yo. I'm like, yo, you good? Yeah. You still hooping on Sunday? 2:00. All right, bet.
Solid.
Well, I cut all my hoes off, so.
You cut them off. When you get into a new situation, cut all your hoes off?
Yeah.
That's nice. That's dope.
I cut them all off. I don't got time. I'm dead. Once that nigga fuck up, I know how to get him back, so ain't no need to.
Oh, you know how to get him
back. I'll be back again. He said, what's he leave?
But I'll be back. She'll be back again.
But you tell me to shut up, I'll shut up.
It don't be more like I'll be back again. They come back once they see that I'm single again, they just jump in the inbox. Like, oh,
they just.
So your boyfriend said you, which I broke up?
Oh, y'all broke up? Now they had done like Trey Songz. Something like that.
But, you know, once I get a relationship, I let them know, like, you know, it ain't none of that, you know. Can't call me all times
in
the night no more.
You run it
with the boyfriend.
You run it all the way down. Like, this is the, I can't do this, and this because I got this.
Yep.
Okay.
Period.
And now what you do?
I mean, you gotta bring them all to the table. Like, you know what I'm saying? You have a meeting and shit. Like, look, I know y'all are, wonder why we all here, but like shit gonna start. It's, you know what I'm saying, we recreating the team. You know what I'm saying? Like, and if y'all want to continue to, you know what I'm saying, do this shit, then we.
Part.
If you want to play on the team is, you know what I'm saying, like, we making cuts and altercations.
So
like,
what
I got
if, what
the
if,
star
what
player if, AI if, has arrived.
What if the new situation is badder than all those? Would you dump everything for the new situation?
I mean. Like, you always say that, like, you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the night, as a man,
hey, yo,
we're going to be fucking these hoes. Like,
care.
Like, you know what I'm saying? You can have Beyonce, but I bet Jay-Z running around still out there fucking these hoes. Because, you know what I'm saying? Somebody's...
You think so?
You know what I'm saying?
You think that? Really?
Big fact. You know what I'm saying? Somebody's everything is somebody's... I'm fucking sick of her ass.
True.
You know what I'm saying?
And it
goes both ways because niggas ain't shit. You know what I'm saying? It go the other way because niggas ain't shit neither. Like, you know what I'm saying? A chick could have, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I seen chickens say, oh, you know what I'm saying? That nigga got money. He take care of you. You don't got to work. How could you do that? You know what I'm saying? Because the nigga not playing his part. You know what I'm saying? Okay, you know what I'm saying? He taking care of the bills. He taking care of everything. You got everything you need. You can get your nails done. You can do whatever you want to do. But he ain't never the fuck around. He ain't got time.
You can have whatever you like.
He don't care. He just throw some money and he leave. So, you know what I'm saying? Now she got time. It's time a window. There's a window open. Yeah. There's a window open for East Zelda to come in the window like.
What is it?
You know what I'm saying? Debo, sleep, nigga. You know what I'm saying? What? You know what I'm saying? And he gonna play his part. Like, you know what I'm saying? And that's the window that's open. You know what I'm saying? But
oh, that's facts.
I have been in a situation where that guy was in the relationship. And now I was just like, I don't know how. You know what? When bitches get mad about being a side bitch, I don't know why. Like, and seriously, I don't know why. Because if you see this nigga cheating on his bitch, why do you want to take him seriously? Same way you gonna lose him.
True.
I have a man. I have a well-known Instagram person. I'm not gonna say his name. He has two wives. That probably should do enough for you. And he posts them all day on Instagram. This nigga stay in my inbox. So my artist told me, he said, yeah, he wanted fuck, right? He said, it's a hotel called the Westin. Tell him to take you to the Westin Hotel since he wanted fuck you.
The Westin?
Yeah.
You ever been to the Westin? That's not a good hotel.
The Westin is.
That's like a two-star.
The Westin is the fucking.
No, not Westin.
I know the same shit. That's not no. No, it's not. Not the fucking one.
The Westin, that shit is expensive.
Right. Oh, wait. That's not the one.
We looked at the room, that shit said $900 a night. So I sent him that shit. Period. Like, here.
Oh, you was like, yeah?
Yeah, because see, my thing is, not only is you cheating on one, but you cheating on two.
Right.
So if you gonna be cheating on women, them bitches gonna come to me as a woman. I need to get my money's worth. I need all that shit. I need a $900 rum. I need to check while you at it. Cause now you got one female.
If a nigga spend $900 on a room, it ain't no check left. Like, I mean, nigga, like, how? Cause how much do some sex cost? I said, God damn.
Money all
that's cool
Instagram.
Too.
He's one of them niggas. So if you know,
no, I can flash all day. I can flash all day. I'm not taking no bitch to no hotel for $900. Period.
That's a vacation.
Yeah, like
I can. Shit, we going to Mexico for 3 days and three nights. I'm about to.
I'm drawing.
I got this flight planner person. Yeah, what? It's all inclusive. Three drinks for $900. That's two people, nigga. And they're no $900 hotel. I ain't never.
You get what I'm saying?
I get it, though.
Like, I mean...
I wouldn't want nobody to spend $900.
But see, the thing... Listen.
Like, if you're
going to
just waste that money, then I'd rather
give
it to me.
My whole point was...
In cash.
Yeah, that too. But my whole point was I was never going to go with him in the first place. I just wanted to see the reaction because... Like, you really up here talking about how much you love them, but secretly in my inbox and texting me how you want to come see me and how you want me to do this and do this.
Every fucking day.
I'm a
side bitch. I can play my part.
This shit ain't new. Like,
I can play my part as a side bitch. That ain't no problem.
How many women are comfortable playing the side bitch?
Is it cool being a side bitch? That's what I want to know.
Like, is it okay?
Is it cool?
Hold on, before before we get in.
You planning on being single for the rest of your life, then?
I respect side chicks. Only because, not that they savages, but I don't know. Like, they do what you don't feel like
they do the intangibles. All right.
So,
they
yo, said,
they like do that. The intangibles.
Honestly, like, go to your side, bitch. You want your dick side? Go to your side, bitch, nigga.
No, seriously.
Wait, if you think about it,
so essentially, just thinking about it. Like, women to men ratio is 5 to 1. Let's be real. It's too many of us. Way too many.
Right there.
Oh, I gotta talk into the mic.
Yeah, your levels is. No, bring the chair. Come on, get comfortable. Yeah. Got the blue lollipop and shit. Okay.
Women of men ratio is 5 to 1, so it's way too many of us. So,
facts.
Like, I'm not the type to play the side chick. I'm the type to be the wife. Like, honestly, you know, I handle the business. I come home. I do what I'm supposed to do. If that's my position that I'm given. And from time to time, I don't want to do the extra stuff. I don't want to have sex. I don't want to suck no dick.
Oh, shit.
You know what I'm saying?
So
I'm
going to still get my check. So,
I'm going to still eat my food. I'm going to still live in my
crib.
So,
hold on. Before we get...
I don't agree with that. Because, I mean, I do all of that. And I still want to...
give the sex and suck the dick.
No, all I the say, time. I do
so
too.
I don't believe in side chicks because I feel like if somebody's with me, they don't have no fucking reason to cheat on me. Facts. Nothing. Period. That part. And they still do. I know, but respect it though.
But hold, we gotta get you to the question though, like, you know what I'm saying? So when you in a relationship, like, do your hoes know that you got a partner and do you put them in a place?
Well, I don't really carry hoes. It's too much of a financial thing.
Wait, my bank account set up. My check and savings, and my savings and my check is.
So. You gotta check them on dates. You gotta make sure that you texting and deleting messages and running around town.
That's too much.
She sound like a nigga bitch.
Like,
that's
too
much. That's real though. That's real talk though.
Are you gonna be doing something else?
Are you straight or bi?
No, I'm straight. She sound like a whole nigga bitch.
Yeah, right. Try to carry it.
That was a carry.
That was a 20-yard carry. That was a first down.
That was
a
first down.
Like, first down. Are you bad? Yes.
It's first down.
You were
the
first one to the whole nigga
saying.
Thank you. Yeah, no, I'm not going to do that. But if you know, if you know for a fact, because you know what kind of guy you dealing with right after the second date, period. Like, if you know he the kind of just try and sneak off and deal with somebody else, that's what you got. So, prepare yourself. Like, mm-hmm. You know somebody is, you know, they about to front line you or they about to come up on the side. Like, introduce yourself.
Right.
I do okay. All the time.
Hello. How you doing?
Yeah, hi, how are you? I'm going to see you more often. What's up? I want to know you.
I ain't going to hold you. If you was to do that to me, I'd be nervous as a motherfucker. Because I wouldn't know how to react.
See, the problem
because I'd be in a mix. So I'd be like, oh, shit.
What the fuck?
Right. Like, it's a setup.
I'm like, wait a minute. She's
like,
too calm.
This is a setup. What he's doing. Like, I know what you're doing. I know where you at. I know who you with. I don't got to worry about what you're doing. I don't got no stress. I come home. I do what I got to do. You go do what you got to do.
As long as everything's taken care of at home.
Pretty much, like I don't
leave
know.
Leave it where it be.
Yeah, no.
But so you
cool?
Like,
with that
it's
though.
Not like I, you know, I respect side girls in that way. You know, like no offense, you know, but I'm just saying, like to a certain degree, when you get to a certain level, then you don't really care about much about who's doing what at that point because you know who you are, you know what you're doing. If that's the kind of dude you with, then you need to be prepared to deal with these kind of chicks.
I'm not saying I didn't get
so you single.
All the time.
Huh? So you single?
No, I'm not.
I got a question. So, are you cool with your man having a side chick? That's what I want to know.
I've dealt with dudes having side chicks while I was with them. And the most that I've done in that situation was, and I've been the chick that was upset at one point, you know, when I was younger and I found out late in the game, like what was going on, and the girl, she got all these histories and stuff with them. I just got to the point where I'm like, okay, I already know that you this kind of dude. Like, you know, I'm preparing myself for the chick that's going to pop up later, just to let you know. Like,
right.
And not that I'm going to let him know that I know what's going on, but I'm going to let her know that I know what's going on.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. Like, that's how it should be. Instead of worrying about what the girl doing, you know, like, you know what the dude doing, you know, you should be friends with her.
You check the home front first.
Pretty much, like, you make sure you cool.
If he puts it on the line, like, look, babe, you A1, but occasionally,
B2.
I'm going to be over here.
He don't have to say that.
He don't got to say it?
Because after the second date, I already know this kind of dude you are.
Second date.
So
how far can that go?
how far can that go?
So how far can a relationship go knowing that side pocket is always going to be there?
Well, this is what I got to say about that. There is women that's married right now that have that situation going on.
Absolutely.
And it's completely secret, facts. But it's known.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. That's stupid. Like, secret but known? Why? Like, you cheating, he cheating. Why can't y'all just say, let's be open? Like,
swing.
Yeah.
Like, I agree with that.
You might as well swing.
You put one in the night, I'm putting one in the
night. You might as well swing.
That's why I was agreeing with you. Like, ain't no need to cheat on me because at the end of the day, I don't want to fuck that bitch with you anyway.
Right. Like, it's secret, but no, that's ridiculous.
Can't we all just get along?
Can't we all just get along?
Don't fuck her first.
Right. And don't fuck her without me.
Because if I don't like the way she looks,
that's a segue into what I was.
And that's a problem, too.
But no. If I like you know what, babe? You know, I might want to have some fun tonight. Bring her home. You ain't got to worry about cheating on this night.
How many women are open to, how many women are okay with an open relationship? Not, or taking it a step upon, like, Listen.
A three-way relationship?
Yeah, when we go out.
What's that shit
you
called?
You pulling or I'm pulling her tonight? What
it's called Lou Williams.
Hey, shit.
Hey.
They carry for 100 yards. Touchdown.
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 Touchdown. How many people are comfortable, yeah, with a three-way relationship?
I am.
I mean,
I'm bisexual. Only because I'm bisexual. If I wasn't bisexual, no nigga. Wow. I can't even say that because, like, before I came out of the closet, like I said, I told my baby father, like, I don't want to suck your dick no more. That's the only pass you can get. And tell that bitch to come here and suck your dick while I fuck you. And then she can bounce and do shit else.
Yonkers.
She get the deep, she get the back of the tonsils.
Yonkers. But what bitch coming just for that?
Oh, right. Wow, trying, bitch can't come.
That bitch wants some dick too. And she said, and she saw some dick. She wants some dick too. Like,
yeah, she not.
She don't want to get short change.
She not just gonna come to let the boss slap her in the face. She gonna want more.
You better find her own nigga dick to ride. You better be happy I let mine put his in your throat. Okay.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay.
That's different. I don't feel like having that in my mouth. And if I want it in my mouth, she can do it.
That's different.
But it ain't no need to cheat because, you know.
I feel like if the lines of communication is all the way open, and I keep it 1,000, well, we, you know, if the guy keep it 1,000 with, this is how I move. This these are the cards on the table. You're either gonna stay or you're not.
Somebody hit me with that before, and I ain't like it.
Yeah.
His cards was out of pocket.
Oh well, the cards is too strong sometimes.
I just feel like for the shit to work, like, you know what I'm saying, for the shit.
I don't like that because it's like you're trying to run a game. That nigga was trying to run the game. Yeah, that nigga put the car. He was like, yep. On some. He do porn and stuff like that. He got strippers. No, he got porn movies and shit. He get the strippers to do porn. He get paid off this shit.
What's his name? Big Daddy Red.
So. No, I'm not on that.
I was just asking a question.
He tried to log on to the website like,
no,
huh?
I've been asking on there. They didn't ask to offer me $1,500 a week to do the shit. And I was like,
I was just trying to figure something out.
But he was on some.
I got you. I'm going to let you get on this in a second, though, but it's a crazy conversation.
Type of shit like, I want you to bring a nigga to my house and fuck him in front of me, and then after you're done, I'm going to eat your pussy. I'm like, hold up. I don't like this. This is too much for me because he into that porn shit. That's what they do in porn. I was like, you know, that's too much for me. If you said something about a female eat my pussy and you wanted to watch, and then we could, you know what I mean? But he said, get a nigga, bring him to my house. Let me watch him fuck you. When he nut, don't clean it off. Let me eat your pussy.
Wait. Whoa. Hold on. It went left real quick.
It went so left. That's what I said. I was trying to make sure.
It went left real quick.
That's what I said. His cards was like, okay, you know.
That's pause first.
I had the messages.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to check.
No, I had the messages is right here.
You want that nigga's what?
That's what turned me off.
Yeah, that's
it turned
a bad
me all
job.
The way off. And I was like, I can't be in this relationship with you because, you know, you want too much. And I don't even feel like, you know, you want me to sit here with this. Even if I can't make it to his house, don't wash myself up. Just come. No,
what?
I don't want to sit with that shit on me. Bro,
you don't wash.
He hard.
What?
Listen,
that's
one
boy,
that
has
some crazy shit in her inbox. Some
bullshit.
With some crazy men. Right.
Mm.
So I'm
going to
say, but, you know, I've been
trying
to
there's
me.
There's a lot of crazy shit going on. Listen, I feel like if you're in a three-way relationship, the only way to make this shit, like, work is for you to work on the two women. Because, like, you got to keep them on the same page and away from few. And, like, one thing about women are, like, hella territorial.
Here's the thing.
Unstable creatures.
I'm going to put myself out there real quick and then. Make sure this conversation never happens again. All right, so look.
On live?
Fuck yeah, I don't care. I was in that situation. So being in that situation, it was kind of like, me and the chick was cool. She was open, like, listen, I'm going to bring you joint to this, you know what I mean? Or if you pick one, we going, yeah,
I mean. No, I don't pick one. That's a trick.
That's a trick.
You pick one. Like,
no, I'm going to let her pick one.
You got to be going out. You pick her and bring her back home.
I don't even.
We're going to move.
I don't even need her.
Here's the problem. You know your female. You know everything about your female. You know where to touch her, what's going to turn her on, everything. The other chick don't. So if I'm touching my chick the same way all the time, I know every spot to hit. This chick, I'm touching her the same way I'm touching my regular chick, and she's losing her fucking mind. She's going batshit crazy. Now my regular's going to have like, well, you kind of giving it to her more. I'm like, no, bitch, it's the same shit. She's never got this shit before. You get it all the time.
You
spoil it. You get it all the time. This bitch ain't never got it, so she like, no, this bitch got to go.
You hear me?
I need what you did to her. To me, I'm like, bitch, I do it all the time.
I just did it. I did it before.
What
I
you should have said was, remember your first reaction was like
and
that?
That's what I said, listen, you don't remember the beginning? You don't remember where it all started at? That's why you here. No, well, she got to go. We can't do this again because you out here trolling.
Oh, you know what?
You know what? Fuck both of y'all. Fuck it went to die. Word. That's why I got back up. My nickname 2 Chainz. I got 2 phones.
DJ 7.
Got 2 so phones.
So, ask y'all a question. Since y'all so hype about a three-way relationship.
I wasn't there and I have a good lawyer.
I mean.
I plead the fifth.
I might as well say something since I brought it up to you earlier, but it wasn't a three-way relationship, though. But, like, y'all, like. So how would y'all feel if a chick had 2 niggas? Like,
first of all, I'm selfish.
Okay. PMB Rock.
Selfish. Real shit. No, that's nope. That's dead. That's nope. Dead.
Excuse me. Is that for the female?
New Lane Entertainment.
No, that's dead.
Or that just for the
no, it's for us. No, it's dead. No. Fuck yeah, no. I don't know. I don't want to share. No. I don't want to share.
I'm sorry. Like,
I'm not sharing.
Believe it or not, no matter what. Okay.
Just not with no other nigga.
They gotta understand with a threesome.
Not with a nigga.
They gotta understand with a threesome and a train is. We had this conversation over last time.
And threesome was with.
A threesome
we're not even talking about threesome.
But would you say
three way relationship?
Okay.
But you just added.
No, but you
were changing it around. Everybody's having relations, okay?
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna be fucking a nigga that's fucking another nigga. That's dead.
Whoa.
Okay. That's a three way relationship. Dead, being dead. A three way relationship is a relationship with all three of us, right? When you have a three-way relationship with a bitch, you want them to eat each other, all
right? Right.
Okay, then. So when
I'm not sword
niggas,
fighting with the next nigga. I'm sorry.
Watch them.
But not necessarily because...
It's a train,
with
baby.
Somebody
I'm
with
not
two,
getting trained.
Somebody with...
I'm not getting
trained.
Somebody with two wives.
Chicka, chicka, chicka.
That means that they're Muslim, and those wives aren't having sex with each other.
They're not, though.
Okay, we know that.
They're not.
They're not.
So what I'm saying is, why can't the... woman have 2 niggas that she now I don't want to do it, but I'm just saying hypothetically.
Okay,
speaking,
so I just feel like
niggas don't like that,
like this,
and that's double standard.
Listen,
I'm
gonna put like this. Have you messed?
And that's just my
have
point.
Have you messed around with not 2 niggas at the same exact time, but deal with 2 niggas at the same time?
Wait, what?
Not messing around with them at the same time, but dealt with 2 people at the same time.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. Like you wasn't sure who you felt both of them, but you didn't know who to pick. Okay, I've been in that situation, so...
Now you suck in between the two.
Yeah, so, like, if you say it, if that's what you're saying, nigga, I've been in something like that, because on the other hand, I was fucking him, but I don't know, like, but then I was fucking him, but then it's like, damn, I want both of them, but I can't have both of them. If you want to say that, then yeah, but as in, like, him being okay with me fucking another nigga, fuck no.
Yeah, I know. Exactly.
Okay
I know
that?
No niggas okay with that. That's my fucking point.
When I say
unless I caught you outside on a late night and me and my man's is there, then I'm okay with it because we're gonna party and send you on the way. Like,
you know what I'm saying? And I'm saying like it's okay that he got that girl and I know he's there. It's because he's not messing with me. Like I'm getting a break. He can have that right now. I'm chilling. When you dealing with 2 dudes at the same time. You're not getting rid of none of that. That's just sitting with you.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. Got to be a double standard for that. That's not clean. Not to me. That's trifling. Like, that's just not cool at all.
I've done it.
It's called wrapping the fuck up, sis. If you out here fucking everybody wrong, you damn right is nasty. It's called condom. You better use them.
Yeah, see,
shit.
That's different. Yo, these girls out here, you know they ain't wrapping
said,
up.
I did.
I ain't got no
fuck
fucking pills.
Shout out to the condom sponsor.
Shout out to condom.
BT said,
wrap
it up.
That shit. If you got a condom on, you don't have
but
to
you know these girls ain't
shit.
Out here doing that.
Well, that's the fuck on them because strap it up, baby. Because guess what? I'm not having no more kids, and I'm not getting no birth control because you wasn't dumping me. Nizno. So you gonna wrap it up or you ain't getting none. You wanna eat the pussy?
Carrie. I forgot why she was the Carrie.
Right.
She ABM 101
Radio. Look, this is the after party show. You know what I'm saying? What we gonna do is we gonna get into some music and shit, and then we gonna come back with Nina. And she got the question of the day. You got the question of the day? You ready for that, John?
You ready for that, John?
Yeah. ABM 101 Radio, man. ABM101.com.
DJ 7. Let's go. Let's turn up.
That's my job.
Oh, I'm sorry. I got carried away.
carried away. You know what I'm saying? We definitely about to get carried away, though. You know what I'm saying?
Not tonight.
Chewing you on this one.
shit barking on little booty matter.
Wow. Advertisement.
Come on.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Where the little booties at? Little booties. Yeah, we're gonna keep it pumping, man. AB on 101 Radio is the after party show, you know what I'm saying? It's your guy, DJ FNI, you know what I'm saying? My nigga DJ 7 with me, you know what I'm saying? We still gonna turn up, you know what I'm saying? That VSOP life. You know what I mean? Y'all niggas already know how we carrying that shit. We get down with the brand down, you know what I'm saying? Y'all already know how we carry that shit, man. It's the Carriers, man. The Carriers mixtape coming out January 1st. So make sure y'all tune in, and man, make sure y'all fuck with that shit, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Got a couple other shit going on, you know what I'm saying? January 22nd, I got Slaying Lingerie, man. I'm
yeah, I gotta get ticket
party,
for that,
man.
John.
Make sure you get your tickets.
I definitely got snap.
Get your ticket.
Purple should actually be in the building doing this promotion right now, but I'm here. You know what I'm saying? And we there. We doing that shit. Slay and Lingerie, December 22nd. You don't want to miss
Slay.
It. You don't want to miss it, man. The first joint, Labor and Lingerie, was Shillit Lit. The second joint, Masquerade and Lingerie, was Shillit Lit. And you missed it. This joint right here is the third installment. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be popping. And guess what? I'm hosting it. And it's going to be Shillit Lit.
Shillit Lit.
And you don't want to miss it. You know what I'm saying? Let's go, Seven. I'm ready. You know what I'm saying? We here.
This is a real job.
It's the after party. It's the after party show.
Got to be prepared.
New paddock on my wrist, yeah.